Okay. So due to crash, we are going to create a new application, but we are going to create a sample application. We are also going to create a capital expense application and workforce application. Okay. So how to create this? So till yesterday we have been seeing on Oracle database, but today we'll see on Microsoft SQL. So for this planning applications also, these are we'll be having the same prerequisites. What are the prerequisites? You should be having a database, you should be having a user, and after that you have to create a data source name. So how to create that? So right now in this particular interface we are going to see into Microsoft SQL. So this is my Microsoft SQL server. I'm logging into this Microsoft SQL Server 2005. So password is password. So now I want to create a database. In this we'll be creating a database like our table space. So how I'm going to create it? Right click on this and I'll say new database. When I say new database, so it is asking for the name of this particular database. So my database name would be, because I'm going to create a sample, so I'm putting name as sample. Okay. And till now I didn't discuss about any owner, so I'm not going to create any owner. So what is the size of this particular sample primary database? It should be 20 MB. Let us say 20 MB. And what will be the size of my log file? It should be 1% of your log file. So means it is nothing but 1% is nothing but 2 MB. Okay. So I have given this and I'm going to say okay. With this my database sample is going to be created. Very simple, right? So now I am able to see my database called as sample. Now I have to create a user. Under security, under logins, we'll be able to see all these users. So I want to create a new login. I'll say login, right click, and I'll say new login. So login name, I'm going to give name as sample. And I'll say SQL Server authentication instead of Windows authentication. And password would be password. Confirmation. Okay. And on which database he should be having access. So I'll go to sample and I'll be providing him access on that. I'll say okay. With this I've defined the user, but I have to define what type of access this user should be having. Right click on this user, go to this properties, and in this go to your general properties or your server roles. User mappings, select your user mappings and select your sample. When you select your sample, below you are able to see the roles. He should be owner of this particular database. Select this and say okay. With this, now my sample user is having database administrator or owner access on this particular sample. Now I am done with my activity. Very simple than your Oracle database. So next thing I am going to do is, I'm going into this Internet Explorer. I'm going to go into logon.jsp where I want to create my sample application. Admin, and password will be password. When I log in, so initially what I have to do, I have to create a data source. So manage data source, and in that create data source. When I click this create data source, it will ask for my data source name. So sample is my data source name, and from which database it is getting, it is coming from Microsoft SQL only. What is your server name? host HOST or HO, let me see, confirm the name. HOST it is. Okay, and your database name is sample. Your username is sample. Your password is password. Now I'll say validate my database. Oh. Okay, let me create a new database then. So let us see. Let us quickly create one more thing. So let Q1 be the database name. So user world got created. Let us try to use this. Why, what the issue was, when I created this particular sample user, I've set this enforce password policy. Whenever I first time log in, it will ask for reconfirmation, new password. So that was the issue. Okay, fine. So we have created a database connection. Now I have to create my server connection. Sbase server connection. Admin. And password would be and say validate my Sbase. So my Sbase connection is also successful. So with this I have created a data source name. Now I have to create an application. So normally how we create an application? By providing your general information, then providing your calendar, then providing your currency, then providing your client type. Okay. In this, I am going to give my application name as okay, I have given sample name, fine. So I am going to give my application name as sample, okay, and I am going to register this under default application groups, instance is default, and I am going to use my business rules. Before that, what I will do is, I will go to my calendar. And in this calendar, I will set this to 2006 because I want my years from 2006 and I will set my total number of years to 10 and come back. Okay, let me fill this again. Sample default application group, business rules. Now, instead of going into all these tabs, I'll say sample application. If you see, there is an option called as sample application, which will create a sample application for your project. Okay. With this sample application, if I say next, where it will skip? It will directly skip to your finish button. So skip to your finish button. Physical start year is 2006. Total years is 4. And at the same time, weekly distribution is even distribution. Currency is USD. Support multiple currency, yes. Standard plan type console. Workforce planning not selected. And it is also not selected. Now, if I say finish, what happens? It will create an application into my SBS database. So this is how you can initialize your sample application. But still, you will not be able to see sample application related information in your planning application. For that, you have to implement one more step. I already have sample. Let me rerun this. Start icon. Record over. Okay, now let me log into my sample application. చూద్దాం తర్వాత నేను చూస్తాను. ఒక 1 అవర్ అయిపోతుంది. 1 అవర్ సో నౌ ఇఫ్ యూ సీ నథింగ్ ఈస్ దేర్ ఇన్ దిస్. సో ఇఫ్ ఐ వాంట్ టు ఇనిషియలైజ్ మై శాంపుల్ అప్లికేషన్ గో టు వ్యూ ఆర్ గో టు ఎడిట్ ఇన్ దిస్ ఇఫ్ యూ సీ దేర్ ఈస్ అన్ ఆప్షన్ కాల్డ్ అస్ శాంపుల్ అప్లికేషన్ అండ్ సెలెక్ట్ దిస్ ఇనిషియలైజ్ శాంపుల్ అప్లికేషన్. వన్ ఐ క్లిక్ ఆన్ దిస్ start initializing your sample application. So what this sample application will have is, it will have already defined outline, it will also have already defined web forms, even ready made task list, all you will be able to see. Whatever we have been doing till now, only ready made options. Take some time and you have to get a message saying that sample application has been initialized successfully. Now if you see in this, you are able to see financial waveforms, revenue waveforms, expense waveforms, allocations. And apart from that, if you go to your dimensions, you will be able to see dimensions also. In this, you will be able to see statistics and all this related information. So looking into this project, I think it will be almost familiar to your real-time project. There are some custom dimensions also. And apart from that, when I come to my business tools, So if I expand my business rules, all these are for your sample application. If I open this add all, it will be used to aggregate your data. So you know what this calculation is? It is just rounding your data. To how many decimals it is rounding? 2 decimals. And they have used a round function. They are using round function. Nothing but operating revenue is a number divided by units. Whatever value you are going to get, for that value it is going to round up to 2. This is nothing but using the round. You know what calcim is and you know what fix is, what set update calc off is and what set aggregate missing on is. Right? And when I go into this particular AGGPLM, let us open this up. So it is aggregating your planned data. So this is also rounding your operate units. Let us see if there are any variables. So you don't have any variables in this. So they didn't use any variables. Calculate revenue. So if you see, you know what level members is, you know what descendants is, you know and or function, and you know what IR sibling is. So, yeah, we have come across calculations, right? I was still in SBS class. Okay. So manaka IR sibling ante telusu, I level members telusu, descendants telusu, is level telusu, you know, and is descendants telusu. So talking about this calculation script is very easy. You can also use substitution variables. Okay. So same way he has written a mathematical calculations in this. You can easily understand this particular business. Try to understand this and try to put it into your Excel sheet. Excel sheet like this, you will understand each and every. Okay. So this is how you can write your calculation. So do you require a real-time calculation script other than this? This is almost a real-time calculation. You can easily sit on it and you can understand. So this is nothing but which is clearing your data. It is going to clear something which is written on your worksheet. Okay. So let us look into global variables. No global variable has been defined. Same way, no variable is also defined till now. And clear final. It is going to clear your data that is present on your final number. And finally, clear your targets. Some targets. Whatever targets you have specified in the business, that it is going to clear. So these are the business rules that are created with your sample application. Now I want to initialize my workforce planning. Same way I want to initialize my capital expense. So what is this workforce and what is this capital expense? These are somewhat ready-made applications which are available on the planning application. So understanding companies, some 100 companies requirement. The 100 companies in this one, workforce is nothing but managing your headcount related information. So our companies know the requirements and anything gather this, they have created an application called as workforce planning. Capital expense, which will deal almost with your expenses related information. Any companies, 100 companies, 200 companies, may study chase, they have developed a ready-made application. What this ready-made application will have is ready-made web forms will be available, ready-made task lists will be available, ready-made members will also be available, like your sample application. Now, let us try to initialize your capital expense and workforce planning. So, how will we initialize it? So, first we need to create a database. New database. So, say give my name as cap and by default size should be 20 MB and your log file should be 2 MB and say okay. After this I'm going to create another database for workforce and say work 20 MB. Now I am going to create a user new logon. So cap is one user, I'll use SQL Server authentication. I'm going to remove this policy. I'll say password as password. Password. And he will be owner on your cap. And user mapping for this cap will be a database name. I'll say I've created cap, same way I have to create a user called as work. Work SQL Server authentication. Password is password. Okay, he will be having access to work and user mapping will be work will be database owner. So we have defined this. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create an application. So first my manage data source, create data source. So what am I going to create? Data source name as cap and server name as host, database name as cap, user name as cap, and password will be password. And validate my database connection with my cap database. And now I am to validate with SBase server. Host admin, password is password. Validate my SBase. So I'll say finish. With this I have created a cap. Now I want to create work also. Work server host. Work is the database name. Work is the user name. Password is password. That is a validate database. Now server name host, user to SBase admin. Password will be password. Let's say validate my application. Let's say now I want to create a capital expense application. Let's say create application. When I say create application, in this I'll give my application name as cap using cap data source. I'll be able to see two data sources, but I'll be using cap with cap, work with work. Where it has to be registered? It has to be registered with default application group, and it has to be registered into default instance, and it is going to use business rules. And calendar, I'm going to specify 12 months. My start year will be from 2006 January. I'll say 10 months, 10 years. Currency, it is going to support multiple currency. USD is my currency. And when I come to plan types, I want a plan type, one plan type I want, and this name should be SAL. Let us give sale, and I want a capital expense plan. And I'll say next. So here it is giving summarized thing, and I'm going to say finish. With this, I've created a capital expense plan, but still your capital expense will not be initialized. How to initialize it? You have to go to view, and in that you have to select initialize capital expense plan. Okay, let this complete. Meanwhile, we will also create work application. So it has created. Let me create another application. I'll click on this. So using your work, I'm going to create an application called as work. Okay. So I'm going to register it under your default application group. Business rule I'm going to use. Calendar as usual, 12 months, making it to 2006. And let me take 10 years. Currency, default currency USD. Multiple currencies are supported. Let me take only one plan type as EMP. And let me initialize work cost. Initially we have taken capital expense, now we are taking work cost. I'll say next, then say finish. So now you have created two planning applications, work and capital. I got my capital and I also got my work posted. Meanwhile, so just keep creating, let it create. So it has created. When I say log off, still your application has not been created. Let me log into capital expense. Still your capital expense of planning has not been created. For that to be created, what we will be doing, if you see your dimensions, they are still empty. They are still empty. So I'll go into edit, and if you see initialize capital asset first. I'll say, do you want to proceed with this initialization? I'll say, what this is going to do is, it will create my EMP database, and it will also create a capital expense here. So this is how you can initialize your capital expense, workforce. So now you are able to see forms, capital web forms. Under this you will be having this menu. Now let us go into dimensions and see. So it is having accounts, system members, and if you see your dimensions, you are having asset class, currencies, entities, line items, period, scenario, version and so what I'll do is I'll quickly do a database refresh. Manage database and also database. When I say database refresh, I can create two plan types. One is your SAM and another one is CAPEX. So if I go into this, I'm able to see capital expense and SAM. SAM outline. It will be having your dimensions, what all dimensions you wanted in this, what all members you wanted in this. But your capital expense will be having all those members that you wanted. You see, these accounts are not flowing into your SAL data. SAL is meant for your purpose. Okay? So this is how you can create your capital expense. Apart from this, what are going to be created? Just refresh my repository. So I am going to get some other calculations or your business tools. So in this business tools, if you go into each and everything and if you look into them, you will understand each and every business. Let me refresh my global business. I am also having global business. So if you go through all this, you will understand what calculations are doing, how explicitly you can write business. Okay. So same way, let us also initialize your log off workforce. So go to edit and say initialize. This will initialize your workforce. For this again you will have different platforms and you will have different business. Our business rules only if you go one by one and if you try to understand them, that is more than enough. So these are my weapons for workforce. These are the total weapons that are used for your workforce. After studying 100 companies, they have developed this structure. If you want, you can develop this by yourself. Workforce is nothing but maintaining your headcount. Capital expense is nothing but maintaining your assets, expenses on your assets. Okay? So let me quickly do this. So it will create EMP and it will also create workforce data. So with this we have created this application. So till yesterday we have been seeing task list, data forms, smart list, user variables, managed properties, dimensions, copy data, clear cell details, alias tables, reporting, statistics, application settings, we know all this. Manage data source, we know this. We don't talk about this. We know what user management is. Security we have been discussing about. We are not going to discuss about this. We know what this managed database does. In this, there are two options. You can do your database refresh or you can refresh your security. Refresh your security will refresh your entire security. But if you go to your security filters, only individual security filters can be refreshed. And your currency conversion, you are familiar, and your exchange rates, you are familiar. Okay? So only thing we are left is with manage menus, and the other one is with your workflow. Okay? Let us take this into consideration and we'll try to understand what this menus are. Okay? So if I want to create a menu, I'll say manage menu. Already there are some, it is default. Okay? So if I want to create a menu, I'll right click on this and I'll go into this and I'll say I want to log into next web form. I'll give some name called as next. This is my menu name. I'll click and I'll go into edit. Just like your task list, this is also menu is also similar. Add change. So your menu item can be a data form, it can be a URL, can be a business tool, or it can be a workflow. If it is a task list, instead of menu header, what you'll be having? You'll be having something called as descriptive. Instead of descriptive, they are placing something called as menu header. Menu header is nothing but if I select this as a menu header, you'll be having menu header by name. So select. Okay. Label, it has to be displayed as select only. If you want any icon to be pulled, you can pull this particular icon. So I'll say save. Okay, this is getting created. Under this, I want to create a change. And this should go into a web form. Next. And what data form you want to select. So that form should be workforce form. And I want to open this particular manage existing. Or I want to go into second web. So this got created. Now I want a sibling where I want to run my business tool. So I'll select a business tool. So I want to run this on my workforce. And I want this particular business tool to run. Headcount related calculations. So let me say calc existing department. Okay. I'll say give something. Same way, you can have a workflow also. Right now, you also can have a URL. So, just we are going with business tool and data forms. I'll save this menu. Okay, I'll close. So, after doing this, Now what I am going to do is, I am going to my manage data forms. I am opening my first web form. And in this particular web form, I am going into other options. And in this, I am going to add this particular menu. Next menu I am going to add. Let me remove this WFP menu. I am going to put only next menu. After this, I am going to save this. After doing this, let me open my first web form. So there are no valid rows for this data. So why this is displaying this? It is suppressing your cells. So I have to unsuppress this. Where we can make this suppress existing cells or suppress hash missing cells means we can go into this other options. Format data, show at least. Suppress missing blocks, suppress missing data. So let us uncheck this. Let me see. Now let us open this particular. When I open this web form, now if I want to go into next web form, I don't know what web form I have to select, but if I right click on this, now you are able to see select, because this was selected as a header, menu header, so I am getting this. Under this, I am able to see next web form. I can go into my next web form thinking of this. Just I can navigate from here. For this purpose, we will be using this menu. Hear about this menu? So I just want a menu under which I want to create my activities. For this reason, we will be using this menu. Task list, you can assign those tasks, but this menu, if you attach it to your web form, you can right click on this web form and you can select appropriate menu into which you want to. So clear about this menu? So this is about your menus. So if I say next, it will go into your next web form. If I say run business rule, it will run my business rule. An error occurred while running this specific calculation script. Check log. Some error is run. Okay. So this is how I can run my business rules with help of menus. So we are done with this menu. Most of the times, task list, menus, we will not be using. Very rarely we will be using. But smart list, these days they are using at a larger scale. Okay. So with this, we are completed about your menus. And the last topic that we have is your workflow. Okay. In a workflow, a user provision on bottom up version can only be involved. So security again we have to initialize. So for that, I'll create some users. I'll go to my shared services. I'll create a user called as workflow 1, workflow 2, workflow 3, workflow 4. I'll create 4 types of users. Login. I'll go into my user directory. Native directory, I'll create some users. So I'll create a user called as workflow 1, providing password as password. Create another user, workflow 2, password as password. So workflow 3. The last user workflow 4. So I have created these users 1, 2, 3 and 4, and I am going to provision one user on this particular planning application as an administrator. He is going to be an administrator. So what application we are talking about? This is work application. So I am going to define him as an administrator. Okay, and save him. Okay, same way, workflow 2, I am going to provision him with interactive user. Because we have discussed about these roles, right? Administrator, interactive user. What can your interactive user do? He can create business rules, he can create web forms also. He can also be involved in your work. Let us workflow 3 and workflow 4, will make them as planners. We'll make these three users as planners, two users as planners. So at a time you can provision 200-300 users at a time. Okay? By selecting them, holding your control. So default application groups work. So I'm going to give them as planners. Let's say. Okay? Now, let us go back to our Hyperion planning application. What we have to do? We have to go to our dimensions and we have to provide security. So what I'll do is, I'll select this member, assign access, and I'll say add access. So administrator, he will be having access on your entire database, so he will not be displayed. So I'll select 1, 2, 3, 4 and provide them write access. On descendants of this member, on this member plus including its descendants, I'll say add. So I'll say yes. With this, your security is enabled on this particular member. So this descending whatever members are there, they are having write access. I selected right. Yeah, write access. So let me select this, assign access, add access. Right, add, and that's it. Let me make on the store also, let me provide him access. Okay. So your account dimension is provisioned with security now. So let me go to employee. Let me see if access is available on this. So access is not generated on this particular custom dimension. Entity, it will be having your security. Only one member is there, I'll say assign access. Add access. So I'll say write access. Let me say including descendants. Add. And under this, let me add some children. No entity. India. Add symbol. UK. Okay. Now, let me go to my period dimension. No security in your period dimension. Same way, let us go to scenario. Your scenario, it will be having your security. See, your scenario is having security, budget actuals will be having security, currently will be having security, no scenario will also be having security. So let us assign this access. Add access, write, add, close, and close. So this is the hectic process that we have in your planning security. Manually you have to go on to each and every member and you have to define the security. Right? Close. Close. current also and add access. Right. Add, close, and the last one is your select. Add access. Right. Add, so we have provisioned this access, but I am opening my budget from, say, from your FY 12 to FY 14. From January to December. I say same way my actuals, I am opening my actuals from, sorry, FY 12 January to FY 12 December. I say, okay, current I am not bothered about, scenario I am not bothered about. Okay. And version, the last thing that I am going to provision. So I have DUI version, first pass, target version, first pass versus target version, and no version. All these versions are present. Okay. Let me take my bottom up version only into consideration. So everywhere user is having write access. In this particular workflow, which version will not be involved? Your target version cannot involve the workflow process. Let's see what the workflow process is. Very rarely they'll be using this option, but try to understand it. So finally we have provisioned each and everything. Now let us do quick first database refresh. I'll say finish, and I'll also say security refresh because we have created some users. And after doing this, the last thing that I have to do is I have to provision users on this particular folders, web forms. So go to manage data forms and I'll say assign access, add access. I'll provide access to all these three users. Okay. So now I have logged in as an administrator. Okay, and log out. Now I am logging as a user called W1. But will it allow me to log in? Yeah, it allows me to log in. Okay. Now, if I open this particular web forms, let me open this particular web form. I am able to open this particular web form. FY06 it is set to. Here it is set to FY06. So what I'll do is I'll edit this web forms. We have to take care of web forms also. We'll take only one web form into consideration. So I'll put FY0. What I can do, I can go to preferences, and I can go to my user variables. So these are set to this year, they are set to FY06. let us set it to FY12. Only one substitution variable will be set at time. Two cannot be set. Now let me open my web form. So now this web form is. Budget version is first pass. Still it is displaying FY06. Instead of it has FY12. Sorry about that. Okay. So now this particular web form is open. What your administrator W1 is going to do is he is going to initiate some workflow process. So what he is going to do is he is going to workflow. He is saying manage process. So for which entity and for which scenario he is going to do and for which version he is going to do this, he is going to create for budget scenario, and he is going to create for first pass version, and when I say go, and for which entity you are going to start this particular plan cycle. I am going to start it for your India, because the web form I am going to do is it for India. So I have started my cycle for India, I have started my workflow. Only your administrators can start this particular workflow, and budget, version and your entity are called as a planning unit. Scenario, version and entity will form a planning unit. Planning unit is nothing but scenario, version and entity will form a planning unit. So I am starting my planning unit for a scenario called as budget, and for a version called as first pass, and for a entity called as India. So now let me go and check into my details. So who has started this? Owner W1 has started this. W2 cannot start this particular workflow process. So no annotations are available for this particular process. So what this W1 did, he has inputted some data into it and he is entering please approve it, and he is setting whom to approve it, W3 to approve it. He is asking W3 user to approve this particular budgeting process. So he will say submit, mostly promote. I am promoting it to my W3. I will say submit. So now who can approve this particular process? I have started this under review. Owner is W1. Who can approve this? W3 only can approve it. So let me come out of this, log off, and now let me log in as W2. He is an interactive user. I'll say login. Application is in maintenance mode. What should I do? Go to application settings and in this make all users. Save it. Login. Now let us log in on W. So log. Okay, because I have been provisioned with access on this particular web forms, I can go into this web form. I can change the data that is present in this particular web form. Right now, I cannot change the data that is present on this particular web form. Who can change this data right now? W1 can change this data if you want. So I can change this data. So I'm making it as active and I'm making this as disability and I'm saving this data. So I asked user to check this particular data. Whom I asked? I asked W3 to check. So I'll log off and I'll log in as W3. I'll say login. So when I log in, if I open my web form, I can review this particular numbers. If I want, I can change something. And what I can do, I can go to this workflow. In file, I can go to workflow. And I can go to my manage process. If you see my process, I will be able to select budget, version, first pass. And when I say go, I will be able to see India, which is under review. I can just go to this details and I can change the status. I can provide an approval or I can provide a sign off. If I provide approval, what happens? That particular web form will be locked. No user can input that data. Only your W1 user can change that data. No other user can change that data. So let me say approve. Approved. If I say submit, so now if you see approved, W3 approved this particular location, and I'll say done. Now let me open this particular web form. Now I'm not able to input data into this particular web form. After reviewing, if I say approved, web form will be locked for all other users. Who user can lock and send on that particular web form or submit data? Only your user W1, because he is the owner of that particular web form. I'll say login, and if I open my web form, I'll be able to change this. Only administrators can change this particular data. This is how you are restricting data. So why this hierarchy is created? In business, what will be the process? There will be a user who will be designing your budget. After designing your budget, he will send it for an approval or he will ask it to promote it to his superiors and get that approved. So after designing this particular budget, he will send it to his superior asking to approve it or provide a sign off. If there are multiple users, they will be providing a sign off. So I ask him to approve it. If he rejects, what I have to do? I have to change my numbers again, and again I have to ask for an approval. All this process is getting tracked somewhere. Where it is getting tracked? It is getting tracked into here. Only W1 can, because he is the owner of this budget. Because he is the designer of this budget. He designed this budget, so he can input numbers into that particular budget. Means, who will be having the authority on those particular numbers? ఆ నంబర్స్ చేంజ్ చేయడానికి అథారిటీ ఎవరికి ఉందంటే హూ డిజైన్డ్ దట్ బడ్జెట్ హీ విల్ బీ హ్యావింగ్ దాట్ వన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అప్రూవ్ అంటిల్ అండ్ అన్లెస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ అప్రూవ్ ఇట్ విల్ బీ ఓపెన్ టు ఈచ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ వన్ మోస్ట్లీ హూమ్ యూ ఆస్క్ టు రివ్యూ ఆర్ హూమ్ యూ ఆస్క్ టు అప్రూవ్ ఆర్ హూమ్ యూ ఆస్క్ టు ప్రమోట్ దట్ పర్టికులర్ వెబ్ ఫామ్ సో టోటలీ హౌ మెనీ స్టేట్స్ వీ విల్ బీ హ్యావింగ్ ఇన్ దిస్ పర్టికులర్ వెబ్ ఫామ్ అంటే మీన్స్ ఇన్ వర్క్ ఫ్లో అంటే యూ కెన్ ప్రమోట్ ఇట్ యూ కెన్ provide a sign off on it, or you can approve it, or you can reject it. Okay, and why we should have different versions? Why we are having different versions in this particular application of that? After finalizing your budget, you want to copy the same budget to another version. So in that scenario, you should. Another scenario and you have to copy the same version or same budget to some other location, to some other entity. Then you can go to this particular file and you can say workflow, copy your version. The same budgeted data, say from budget and copy from first pass to which version you want to copy. I want to copy it to no version or I want to copy it to target version. And if I say go, it's all level will be copied over from bottom up version to a target version. And on what entity you want to copy this particular data? I want to copy it on India only. If I say copy data for further analysis, further reporting purpose, you can copy your you can take your budgeted data onto another entity and you can start again budgeting on that particular. So this workflow process in your 11.1.1.3, say if I'm asking for a sign off, if that user didn't approve it for 1 week, then what user can do? What workflow user W1 can do is he can change the approver. He had an option to change the approver, but in 11.1.2, if you are setting a user to approve it, only that user can approve. And who can initiate this particular workflow? And only administrators can initiate this particular workflow. And who all can approve this? Planner can approve it. Administrator can approve it. Interactive user can approve it. All users can approve it, depending upon the member that you are going to select. He should be having access on this particular. So, how your data is getting restricted? See if your user is not having from a shared services level access onto this application, user cannot log into this particular planning application. And next, if user is not having access on that particular member, he cannot approve that member, right? Because he is not having access. Is not having access, he cannot approve it. So he should be having access on it. After having access, he should be having access on that particular web. Then only he can review that web form. After having access on that particular web form, your scenario should be opened. Otherwise, you cannot read that data. After having your scenario opened, finally, if your budget is approved, still your sales will become read only. In this many ways you can block your web form. In all these areas you can block your web form. So this is how your workflow works. Mostly workflow, if you see, if you see it is up to, and if I go into my details, so I can look at my details also. First I asked for a review. Whom user I asked? I asked workflow 3 to review this particular status. After reviewing this, he approved it. Now I am owner of this particular web form. Only the user W1 can log in. If W2, W3 or W1, W4 logs in, they will not be able to input data into this particular web form. Just to restrict your web form inputting data, they are using this particular workflow process. In case if you are not having this workflow process, what is the process is in our real time? Right now we are following the same process, but we are not using workflow. Once users input their web form data, they'll ask us to lock your web forms. So how we are going to lock our web forms? I'll go to administrator, manage data forms. I'll go to workflow. I'll edit this web form. And I'll make this particular web form, I'll go to other options and I'll make this web form as read only. So this web form will be in read only mode. This way we are going to each and every web form and we are making it as read only. So if there are 100 web forms, we are going to make them as read only. But in this process, you have completed your activity for India. So what I can do, just I will say approve. Means all web forms with India will be locked, only one user can access it because he is the administrator of that particular budgeting process. So this way they are using this particular web form. Mostly in our current process or in regular business process. And they'll be having a mail. Mail bomb is coming. They'll send a mail saying that please close this web form. But in this case, you need not send a mail. Owner of the web form will be sending. Log this web form. Instead of that, I'll go into this workflow. I'll check the status. I'll check the status for budget, because right now budget scenario is going. I'll say go, and in this I'll go into this details and I'll see. Okay, it is approved. So he said this particular business or this particular web forms have to be logged. So I'll go and say, I'll just say approve it, so that gets logged. Even he need not send a mail to me. He can directly say approve. It will log all my web forms. I need not go and log. So it is reducing administrator activities. From end user, he is going to do each and every activity. So I think even your interactive user can also perform workflow initiate workflow process. So let us see W2. If user has rejected, you can again, you have to again review all those performances. Yes, again you have to review. Promote state. He is going to promote to his superior. In that case, only that user, superior user and administrator can look into that particular numbers. So let us try to initiate a workflow. So let us do it for BUI version. So you have not planning, you have no planning unit started for the selected scenarios and version. Means workflow cycles can be started only by an administrator. Only administrators can start your workflow process. Even interactive process users cannot initiate workflow process. Okay, this is one more point that we have to keep in mind. And if you see, you are not able to see your target versions, because target versions are not involved in your budgeting workflow process. So this is about your workflow. I think bit ka artham avutundi, but still why this is used is to lock your web forms down. So no other user is going to update that particular web form data. But you can lock and send using your Excel add-in or using your Spark. This is going to work only up to your planning application. From SBS database, I can right click or I can load data with help of root file again onto each and every combination. It is not only from web forms point of view. Okay. So this is about your workflow. The last one discussed is my task list, menus, workflow. These are not used that much, but still have a knowledge. In workflow, you can have promotion, rejection, approval, sign off, review. You can have this many characters. Totally we can have 6 things. First pass review, second review, third review, all this comes under review. Okay. So with this we'll complete our planning. This completed our planning application. So next thing we are going to discuss tomorrow is financial reporting and web analysis. Totally we'll complete tomorrow and we'll try to start. So what we discussed today is, we discussed how to use Microsoft SQL, how to create a database, how to create a sample application, how to... We didn't create any sample application before. Sample application is one which is not related to your capital expense and which is not related to your workforce. Sample is an example application, just like your SBS applications. Whenever you create a SBS server, you will get this sample application, CSO, SAMP, demo, demo, DM demo, sample, sample 1, all these applications will be getting. Same as in planning also, if you want to initialize your sample application, we did that how to initialize a sample application. We also initialized capital expense application. We also initialized workforce activation. And your activity is go into each and every business rule, try to understand all these business rules. Try to differentiate how many types of global variables we can have, because a dimension can be a global variable, member can be a global variable, all types of global variables, try to understand them. And apart from that, try to understand exchange rate, currency conversion calculations. You understand all these things, calculations. And we have also discussed how we are going to initiate menus, and we are also discussed how to initiate your workforce planning with help of three users: workflow 1, 2, 3, and 4 users. Workflow 1 is an administrator. Only administrators can initiate workflow process or planning unit. So what is a planning unit? Planning unit is nothing but scenario, version, and entity will together form a planning area. And how many dimensions are secure dimensions? Your scenario, version, entity, and account. Extra account is a planning unit is different, plan type is different, and security is different. Very similar they will be, all these three things. The more similar you are, planning unit is nothing but scenario, version, and entity. Secure dimensions, scenario, entity, version, and account. And apart from that, plan types are your database. There is a very slight difference in naming itself. Everywhere you will see plan. Plan type, plan unit, security. Okay. So with this we have completed planning. So in planning, almost we have covered each and every topic in this. So we didn't go into broadcast messages. We don't require this. And we have seen all these options. Apart from your copy document link and data load administrator, and in view we have seen basic mode and advanced mode also we have seen. This is nothing but if I don't want to see this particular Oracle in this tab, if I uncheck this view pan, it will remove my view pan. If I want my view pan, I'll check this. If I want to remove this option, I'm going to view and I'll say this will do. If I want that back, I'll be selecting. And apart from that, in edit, this edit will be enabled based upon the activity that you have opened. So in this we have seen drill through is not that much. Launch a business tool that you can also do from here, business tools. And in this you can export your web forms into Excel sheet. So how to export my web form into an Excel sheet? I want to export this particular web form into an Excel sheet. So to export this, I'll say spreadsheet export. If I say spreadsheet export, it will be exported into Excel file. I'll say save and I'll say save. So why do we need to export this? And most of the users will be very familiar with your Excel. So we have to export it to your Excel format and from there you can start using it. But directly you cannot use this thing. What is the problem in this is, in this particular Excel sheet? Problem with this particular Excel sheet is, in this, wherever you see spaces, these spaces are not identical to the space that you provide in your Excel sheet. Your planning space is different, because it is using some different ASCII code, and this Excel is going to use some different ASCII code. So what you have to do is copy this, replace this with your space again, because that space is different and this space is different, and say replace. So it has replaced three spaces. Now your SBase will recognize. See, I can go into this, I can say connect. Say okay. So where is our application? This is from Capital, right? I'll say. And if I say okay, say yeah, first class. think database refresh should happen. So I have to connect to workforce, right? Able to retrieve my data. There I have selected my smart list, but in backend how it is getting stored? It is getting stored in format of 1, 2, the ID that we create when we are creating smart list. 1 ante nothing but active, 3 ante disabled. You can see in this waveform. So activity, disability. So these are replaced by your. So this is how you can export it, but if I want to export this particular web form into SmartView, go into file, open in SmartView, yes, this will directly open my, oh, I have to start my provider service. If your SmartView has to work, means your provider service should be working. So if you start your provider services, okay, I can start it. Now let us export it into your Excel sheet. So it will open your application in Smart. So it will open it in directly, you can start working on this. Webform itself you can start working. So from here itself you can start opening your webform in planning in SmartView, or also you can open it in your Excel add-on. So these are the two options that we have. And you know preference. When you will go into preference, for setting your user variables, most of the times it will be going into your display options. You can change your colors and all. For that purpose, you will be using UI, user interface thing. If I want, I can change it to this. So it has changed this to white color. So if I want this to be reset, I can reset it. So this is display options. I can make it as that. So display options, printing options, all these are there. Your application settings are there. We don't require. And for this particular application, what alias is set? Default alias. You can set your alias here. All these things are. These are not that much required. Only your user variables are. What is the supporting details we have discussed? Supporting details. Supporting details. Supporting details. Edit, let me make it open to FY12. Suppress. Supporting details I have discussed. When you double click in a cell, you can have detailed information about the data in that particular cell, right? You can like double click on this and you can have no supporting details is available for this sheet. Plus, minus, add, change, add. Okay. And you can also have a cell text. Cell text support. So maximum things we have discussed. So if you want, if you don't have some information, if I list something, you can go in, select this option and select this option, help. On this particular option, we will be getting a help button. Yes. planning administrator guide, what I can do is I can select into context. So you have each and everything, how to create a planning application and all this related information. Working with task list, working with data forms, entering data, working with business rules, adjusting and spreading data, working with supporting details, working with currencies, managing planning units. This is nothing but your workflow. And setting user preferences. You can add this to your favorites. So I want this to be added. Oracle Hyperion Planning Fusion Edition User Guide. This is the user guide that you are going to. So in favorites, you can see whatever you want, you can look. So contents legally, any topic you are getting doubt, you can just check it. Okay? So this is. So with this, we are going to stop the plan. Let me stop all my planning. Yes, supporting details can be pulled, the text can also be pulled, everything. Awesome. You have to select the planning details in effort instead of selecting this. Yes, based, there are like four types of database connections. You can have MSBI, SAP, and you can also have planning details, HFM, and you can have SBIS. Four types. You got something not completely. Workflow, I think it is confusing. So if you want, you can take this